Hi and welcome to this Roomba extreme test. Now this here is the Roomba pet series from Irobot, which is to be the strongest of the robot dust suckers we have here. I'm going to do a little extreme test here, and it's going to be a while, so I'll break in the middle of the video here and then come back later to so we don't have to record a whole hour or something. But what I'm going to test here is our bedroom. Underneath here in the bed, you'll see what normally happens if people are sexually active. You are going to collect a lot of dust from the mattresses and so on. As you can see here, there's plenty of dust here for several months. So I'm going to test the sucker here to see if it can cope with the situation here, just for fun. So I hope it survives the test, and let's just start it out and see what happens here. So just to let you know here, I have just cleaned out the tray, so it's totally empty here, so we can see how it collects the dust here. So alarm press clean, and it will start on its journey here. First it's circling around a bit here, that's normal, and then it will start going around the shapes. And we'll see what happens here, if it copes with the feet of the bed and so on. Of course it can't drive over the bed here, but that'll do just fine. As you see now, it will turn around. I'll follow a little bit here, and it's going to start eating up here all the dust and so on. And as you see now, it's spinning around and blinking blue. That's where it finds extreme dirt. That's what they call the spot detection. So I'll let it roll around here for a period to see what's going on, and I God bless let you sit here for a while I pause the video, and then we'll check the results. Of course, up in the end of the bed, there's a spacing from the legs up to the wall where it can't get in, so I would have to pull out the bed when it's done to let it go through there, or use normal vacuum cleaner. But as you see here, this might be a lot easier than to get your own vacuum cleaner underneath the bed. So let's see how this is going, and I'll be back in a while to check out how the result is. But as you see now, it's working pretty well on the job, so I'll be back later. Okay, I'm back. It has been vacuumed now for about, say, 2 or 3 minutes. And I thought, why not try to set the camera up and cover it a bit so it wouldn't eat my camera. And then in the final video, I might just speed up that part so you can see that there was no fiddling with the video. So I'll let it continue here and filming underneath our bed. And you can see when it's passing along the camera and so on, and we'll see what happens.
Insert go in. Batman. Eat them up, yum yum. Yum yum. Yum yum.
Hi, I'm back, and it seems that the vacuum cleaner has reported done a few minutes ago. I'll drag the camera out again here and get it off its tripod. It has been vacuuming now for around 12 to 13 minutes or so, and let's have a little look here underneath the bed. As you see now, it looks pretty neat. There's not much dust left. There's a few old stripes that might need a piece of cloth or something. But besides that, it looks pretty neat. And of course, in the back end here, zoom in, there will be some dust underneath legs and on the other side, because I haven't pulled out the bed yet. But as you see, the full picture here, it has done a pretty neat job. So let's look here and see. It's beeping at me. Let's check out here how much dust it has eaten off the floor here. So as you see, it's doing a pretty neat job. So all this dust here is collected from underneath the bed. I'll just put it out here and let the camera down a minute and let's clean this out and check underneath. There's some dust. There's nothing really here stuck, so it's done a pretty neat job. I'll plug in again, and as you see here, it does a pretty fine job collecting the dust here. So that's my little hardcore test of the vacuum cleaner. So I heartily and strongly recommend this project to others. So, have fun!